Thank you, Stefan. That was a very nice introduction, and as they say, brevity is the soul of wit. So, usually it's, here's a man who needs no introduction, because he just doesn't deserve one. But, anyway, my name is Pierce. I want to start off with a song by a friend of mine named Mark Hurd. He was a wonderful songwriter. And since we're somewhat close to Satellite Beach, I thought it would be good to do a song called Satellite Sky. Oh, why do I lie awake at night? Think back as far as I can to the sound of my... You know, I can't see very well. I'm trying to... The sound of my father's laugh outdoors, at the thought of Sputnik in free flight. Before I could fashion my poverty, before I distrusted the night, I must have known something, I must have known something. I live for those times tonight. Why, mama, why? Why can't I sleep in peace tonight underneath the satellite sky? It can't be easy for my children. I'm hollow before my time. Looks like a desert here to me. Where's the promise of youth for my child? And where are the faraway kingdoms of dreams? We've been to the moon, this troubling home. Vanished in the mist with St. Nicholas and ghettos and war zones. Why? Why, mama, why? Why can't I sleep in peace tonight underneath the satellite sky? I want to stand out here in the middle of the street, listen to the stars. I want to hear their sweet voices. I want to feel the big bang right on my bones and laugh with the children. I want the sparks to ignite before they find out what it means to be born into these times. Why, mama, why? Why can't I sleep in peace tonight underneath the satellite sky? Why? Why, mama, why? Why can't I sleep in peace tonight underneath the satellite sky? Take a minute and catch my breath because I have asthma. Excuse me. That's what we call musical hyperventilation. Because when you have asthma, you have a paper bag and you go, but instead, I can go, which is far more musical. All right. This is kind of a new song. That I wrote during our house arrest we were all under as a nation. And
My youngest son has a Jewish ancestry through his mom. He had a Jewish granddad. And this song is called Jacob's Song, so I dedicate it to him, to any of you who are of Jewish descent, and my friend Richard. It goes like this. Long ago, I pulled a fast one. I pulled the wool over Dad's eyes. Though I was the second son, I walked away with first prize. Still recall my brother's rage. I can see his trembling hands saying, we'll meet again one day, and I will kill you where you stand. My mother said, you are in danger. Get out of here while you still can. I left a wayfarer and stranger. Never saw her face again. Traveling across the open desert till I thought that I would die. I dreamed I saw a golden ladder reaching clear up to the sky. So who's your daddy? What's your name? I've got your number. I'll put you in your place. You play with fire and you'll get burned. But for some, well, that's the only way to learn. I settled in a far-off country. Took 14 years and two wives. Working for my crooked uncle. Glad we got out of there alive. So I took my little family, bound for a home I hoped we'd find. And then came word that made my heart freeze, saying your brother's close behind. But who's your daddy? What's your name? I got your number, boy. I'm in your face. You fight with angels, you'll get burned. Fight with angels. I screwed that up. And you'll get hurt. And that is just what you deserve. So I held my wives and children. I sent them ahead and said goodbye. All by myself I stood there trembling, knowing I would surely die. Then I saw my brother coming, 400 horsemen at his side. But he came weeping and embraced me. You can imagine my surprise. Who's your daddy? What's your name? I've got your number. Well, let me set you straight. When you're in hot water, you will see. That's the best way to get you clean. Who's your daddy? What's your name? You got a new one now. You're not the same. Just a minute, not so fast. Now your name is God, just kicked your ass. Long ago, I pulled a fast one. Thank you. Thank you very much. By the way, I just want to say a word of thanks to the staff here at this place. They are the nicest people I think I've worked with in a long time. I want to get this. Hang on. My name is Pierce Pettis. That's actually my name, believe it or not. And just to prove my point, I brought visual aids. That's Pierce Pettis, as you can see. And Pierce is an Irish name. In Ireland, it just means Peter, you know. But in Northeast Alabama, where I grew up, it means punch this kid in the face, you know, pretty much. So I've had an interesting life. I started out at a little place called Muscle Shoals Sound Studio when I was a teenager. And it was cool because there was a lot of rhythm and blues going on, and I was just playing little folky songs, you know. But I learned how to do this. They had all these songs that had that in it. That's a pretty cool lick, at least for back then. But now it just sounds like a Cialis ad, you know. It's like, when the time is right. But at any rate, I got with my buddy Tom Kimmel, who's also from Alabama and loves Muscle Shoals. So we thought we'd write a Muscle Shoals kind of song. So we did this. Well, there's no need to hide what's going on. Your story's all over town. It's all right if everything is all wrong. Come on down to the crying ground. There's dark skies, feels like rain. Why look at all the thunder clouds? I bet that dam is just about to break. Come on down to the crying ground. Down, down to the crying ground. Let your tears be holy water. Ooh. Down your face, it ain't no disgrace. Come on down to the crying ground. Well, I know you'd love to steal away where you will never be found. Sometimes everybody's gotta feel this way. Come on down to the crying ground. Down, down to the crying ground. Let your tears be holy water. Rolling down your face, ain't no disgrace. Come on down to the crying ground. No need to tell me what you're going through. Sister, I've been right where you are now. You know exactly what you need to do. Come on, down, 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 down. Come on. Down, 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 down. Come on down, 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 down. We are talking holy water. Rolling down your face, ain't no disgrace. Come on down to the the crying ground. Down to 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 the crying ground. Thank you. Oh, there we go. Well, Stefan wanted me to play this next song, and I never refuse a man who signs my checks, and so, damn it, you laughed at Richard's jokes. Loosen the hell up, will you? I'm gonna drink some more of this stuff. Can I say bad words? I probably can't. Yeah, it's public space, okay. Some of this doo-doo right here. Yeah, that's right, it's kryptonite. Notice it glows. What doesn't kill Superman makes me stronger. And I think Nietzsche might have said that. Actually, I like what Norm MacDonald said. He said, what doesn't kill you actually makes you weaker. And next time, it'll probably kill you. Well, at any rate, I have a lot of Florida connections. I was born and raised in Alabama, but when I was about 5-6 years old, my parents, we all moved down to Hollywood, Florida. This was in the early 60s, and there were still woods down there. We played in the woods. Can you imagine that? And all the little kids, all we ever wore were little short pants with elastic, you know, and a t-shirt and flip-flops, and that's all we wore. And we lived in these little cinder block houses with, you know, seahorses on the front and, you know, no air conditioning. Didn't even think about it. We had the best time, but unfortunately, my father's business went down, so we had to go back to Alabama and try to start over, and we did. But I have an uncle who was a professor at University of Florida. My sister and I went to Florida State. My uncle actually coined the phrase arrive alive. That's the truth. His name is Aubrey Pettis. You can look it up. Or was. He's dead now. Because if he was alive, he'd be like 120 years old, I think. That'd be something, too. Well, anyway. So when I was a kid, we would take vacations to Florida. We'd visit my uncle, you know, and we'd hang out. And this was before Disney World, so we would go to Disney World for sailors, which was Weeki-Wachee. And my dad was in the Navy, and he loved looking at the women swimming around, breathing through that garden hose or whatever it was. And my mother would get, you know, angry. And but anyway, I wrote this next song after I pulled up an old home movie. My parents went into assisted living, and my sisters and I went to clean everything up, and I found the old movies, and nobody watched these things for years, right? So the first thing I found was this canister, you know, and I slapped it on the old bell and howl and turned it on, and what I saw was a homecoming parade. Now, if you grew up in a small town, that is a big deal. In small towns, homecoming parade, I mean, you have two calendar events, really. You have the homecoming, and then you have the county fair, and the rest is just a lot of quiet desperation, you know. And anyway, so, and everybody shows up for the homecoming parade, and that's the big deal with the floats and everything. And so my dad had his little movie camera, and he's like panning the crowd, you know, and lingering on the majorettes a little too long, and then we see my mother's angry face, and then it ends, you know. But that inspired me to do this song that Stefan likes, so here we go. This is called Alabama 1959. Chicken wire floats in the big parade, marching bands and the prom queens wave. From an old home movie faded with time, Alabama 1959. Daddy had hair. Mom was thin. Look at the silly clothes they wore back then. Studebaker truck parked in the drive. Alabama, 1959. Men wore hats and called you son. Children said, yes, sir, yes, ma'am. Ladies called you hun. Days just blew away like dandelions in Alabama, 1959. The TVA strung power lines, lit up our world with Pepsodent and Lucky Strikes. And the TVs rolled in black and white. Alabama, 1959. Football games beneath the lights, and no one ever dared to cross the color line. Black faces watched through the fence outside. Alabama, 1959. Don't use that word, my mother said. It isn't Christian, say colored folks instead. And so I learned to be polite in Alabama, 1959. Old home movies, they make me cry, and still I bring them out and watch sometimes. And all those ghosts come back alive. Alabama, 1959. Alabama, 1959.
Thank you.
Oh, cool. Well, thank you very much. Well, Sunday is Father's Day. Hey, lamest holiday ever. Okay. For dads, I mean, Mother's Day comes along, you take mom to dinner, mom gets flowers, mom gets... What do we get? Like a freaking tie, maybe? Some cufflinks? And I get blamed, mostly. That's what I get. I thought I'd do you guys a song for Father's Day. And it's also... interestingly enough, happens to be the title song for my most recent CD, which is for sale in the lobby. You could get one for your dad. Think about it. Not only that, but I have t-shirts that say, Father, Son. You could get that for your dad. He would open up that package and say, you know, you shouldn't have. My dad would probably say, anyway, so. Though you're weary and worried, though you stumble and fall, surrounded by trouble, with your back to the wall when you're busted and broken. Remember the one you'll always be, your father's son, when you're brought down in hatred, when you're brought down by love, brought down by those things you just can't rise above, when you stray from the path and hate what you've become, still you remain your father's son. Your father's eyes, your father's name, your father's pride, your father's shame. Be you braggart or humble, be you doctor or thief, if you're made out of money, if you live on relief, well, still you cannot escape it. No matter how far you run, or you will remain your father's son. Your father's hands, your father's face, and so here you stand in your father's place. You may never have known him, you may know him too well, he may have given his blessing, he may have given you hell, but if you know the difference between right and wrong, then don't forget what you are, your father's son. Hey, don't forget who you are, your father's son. Thank you very much. Ooh, I should turn this off while I tune. There we go. Oh, this song has a, this is, speaking in tongues. This next song has a Florida connection. It's a song I wrote about my friends Pat and Vicky Murphy, who eloped many years ago. It was a true case of love at first sight. They eloped, and they have now been married for, I think, 45 years or something. They raised some great kids, and but their story began here in Florida. Vicky, at the time, was a 17-year-old, innocent 17-year-old little girl, really, and Pat Murphy was a biker dude from New Jersey. And they met in Daytona Beach during Bike Week, which is a truly terrifying event if you've ever been there. And Vicky, by the way, was the daughter of a full-bird Air Force colonel. Should throw that in. And so they met, and they eloped on Pat's Harley. They took off with the Air Force in hot pursuit. And so I told that story to my friend Dana Cooper, and he said, man, that'd be a good song. So we wrote this one. It's called Rodeo Around the World. Excuse me. Ah, I gotta pop my fingers. All right. There. Okay. I hear your wicked laugh, sunlight through an open window, all around your angel face. I swear I see a halo, long hair and your dress undone. You're innocent and shameless, more fun than a loaded gun. Every bit is dangerous. Oh, what I want to know is, will you be my girl? Oh, baby, we can rodeo around the world. Go west, young man, go west, young woman. We'll follow the sunset down just to see where it is going. Just pack one change of clothes. Don't give your folks no warning. Nodding off to the radio. We'll be in Texas by morning. And oh, what I want to know, will you be my girl? Will you be my girl? Hey, we can rodeo. Rodeo. Baby, every true romance is a wild and a risky business. There's danger in that dance. That's why we can't resist it. So are you in or out? No time for hesitation. It's reckless love, no doubt. But I'm fed up with patience. Oh, what I want to know, will you be my girl? Oh, baby, we can rodeo, rodeo around the world. Oh, what I want to know, will you be my girl? Will you be my girl? Oh, baby, we can rodeo, rodeo around the world.
Thank you. By the way, I would also like to give a big word of thanks to Chester, our sound man, for putting up with me. I appreciate that. I drink some more water. I just turn into like Kim Carnes or something, or Lizard Boy. It gets really bad. I turn into, you know, I don't know, Tom Waits, maybe. Your piano's been drinking. I'll have some of this one now. It looks pretty good. I got this at the hospital. I don't know what it's for, but sure does taste funny. Anyway, there we go. This will be another Father's Day song, except it's from the other direction. It's toward the sun. Not the sun, but the, never mind. Anyway, I hyperactivity kind of runs in my family. You'd never know that, would you? We have this stuff called attention deficit disorder, and I'm all my kids had it, except my youngest. My youngest is a smart one, you know. He didn't turn out like that, and the others are musicians, so what can I say? But, yeah, I guess they got it for me because I had it as a kid, though. They didn't know what it was back then. My mom just thought I was possessed by the devil. That was pretty much it. But my oldest son and my daughter have sort of the space shot version, you know, where they're not really hyper. They're just kind of wandering around like helpless cattle or something. And but my middle son, George, got it in spades, man. And that was, he had the, his is ADHD. And ADHD means you're going to get calls from the school saying, you'd better come down here, you know. And we had a lot of those calls. Of course, he's working on his doctorate now, so I guess it worked out. But at any rate, I wrote this for George. This is called Black Sheep Boy. I think I should turn this on. What do you think? There we go.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, the black sheep boy, he's a son of mine, and I love him for his wicked grin and the mischief in his eyes. And he would not harm a soul, he would not hurt a fly. It's just beyond his control to walk a straight line. He's a black sheep boy. He's a black sheep boy. Oh, the black sheep boy strikes again. A delight to all the ladies and trouble for the men. He's bound to break some hearts, kiss the girls and make them cry. Just hope one of those hearts doesn't turn out to be mine. Oh, the black sheep boy. Oh, the black sheep boy. I can see the hurt that he tries to hide. Even when he laughs out loud, he blames himself inside. Can't stop his hands or make his feet be still. Tells himself he won't, but he knows he always will be the black sheep boy. Curly-headed black sheep boy. Skipping out my door goes the black sheep boy, and whichever way he runs, he's gonna make a lot of noise. And I'm startled by the silence the minute that he's gone, and I pray for his protection and leave the porch light on for my black sheep boy. For my black sheep boy, yeah. Oh, the black sheep boy, curly-headed black sheep boy. Oh, the black sheep boy, yeah. Oh, the black sheep boy, curly-headed black sheep boy. Oh, 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 oh.
Thank you. Well, I have a very dear friend here tonight. My old friend, I shouldn't say old, Greta Larson is here, and if you guys would indulge me, I'd like to do a song just for her. This is just for you, Greta.
am a wineman for the county. And I drive the main road, searching in the shine for another overload. I hear you singing in the wild. I can hear you in the wine. And the Wichita wineman is still on the wine.
Okay, I'm going to switch this real quick. All right, I do this. What's the next one I do here? Oh, God, I got the wrong guitar. Okay, I'll just switch it off anyway. I'll bring this one. This is my Vegas act, so if it gets too slick for you, let me know and I'll tone it down. Voting in South Florida. All right, there we go. All right, there we go. Oh, they hate me now. All right. Well, this is a song that was written by the Delmore Brothers. Probably your favorites, mine too. And it was recorded by Doc Watson, because he grew up in North Carolina listening to the radio, and the Delmore Brothers had their own radio show in Decatur, Alabama. And they wrote this little song, and later on, Jason Isbell and Tommy Emmanuel did a nice cover. But you're going to have to listen to mine. So it didn't go like that at all, because I got the wrong harmonica right here. Yeah, that's right. So let me just change. I could do a Dylan song, though. This Bengal dwarf is a bull cat. Okay, nothing. All right, moving on. I know what I did wrong. Excuse me. There we go. Yeah. All right, imagine this. You're at your job and 100 people come in and stare at you while you screw up. Imagine your embarrassment. Here we go. Let it rain a whole lot more, cause I got them deep river blues. Let the rain drive right on, let the waves sweep it long, cause I got them deep river blues. She's a good old pal. She walked like a waterfowl, and I got them damn river blues. Hey, there ain't nobody gonna cry for me. Fish all go out on the spree when I got them damn river blues. I'm gonna sail her shell float, cause I got them deep river blues. Yeah, I'm going back to muscle shows,
times are better there, I'm told, 'cause I got them tears. River blues. Thank you. I'll do a kind of a new song. Well, it's not kind of a new, it is a new song. This is called Diego. And it's just a song about a mother's love for her little boy. I could do anything for you, I'd do that for you, Diego. If I could make any dream come true, I'd dream that dream for you. Days from California, the pilgrim way to Arizona, to El Norte, rise where the air is fresh and cool. Wash and dress for school, Diego. So you won't have to do the work I do, cleaning houses, sorting fruit, Diego. The chambermaid for wealthy gringos, you'll be someday an hombre rico in El Norte. A chambermaid for wealthy gringos, you'll be someday an hombre rico. Always pray the saints to guide you in El Norte. May happiness find. Thank you. We got just a couple more, excuse me, to do. This is a song that I really like. I wrote it a few years ago, and I like it a lot, and not just because it helped pay for my house, but, you know, I like it. When I wrote the song, I didn't have a house. I was broke. I was living in this crappy apartment, and
I didn't even have furniture, man. I didn't even have a table in my kitchen, so I'd just go in there and sit on the floor, you know, and eat Pop-Tarts or whatever. But I started working on this song, and I got with my friend Gordon Kennedy, and we finished it. And lo and behold, it was recorded by Garth Brooks, and it was this big hit and everything. And but it's ironic because the song is called You Move Me, right? So I got to move, you know, after that. So anyway. And as far as I know, it's the only country song I've ever heard of that has psychotherapy as a central theme. Not that there isn't a need for that, but you know. Here's how life seems to me. Life is like therapy. It's really expensive with no guarantees. And as I lay on the couch with my heart hanging out, well, I was frozen in fear like a rock in the ground. Oh, you move me. You gave me courage I did not know I had. Oh, you move me. I can't go with you and stay where I am, so you move me. Yeah, yeah, you move me. Here's how love was to me. I could look and not see. Going through the emotions, not knowing what they mean. And it scared me so much that I just would not budge. I might have stayed there forever if not for your touch. But you move me out of myself and into the fire. Oh, you move me, burning with love and hope and desire. And you move me. Yeah, yeah, you. Go whistling in the dark, making light of it, making light of it. I will follow with my heart, laughing all the way. Oh, you move me. You've got me dancing and you make me sing. Oh, you love me, and I take delight in every little thing, 'cause you move me, yeah, 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 you move me. See how, you move me, how you move me. See how you move me. How you move me. See how you move me. How you move me. Yeah. How you move me. Yeah. Mm-hmm. you move me. You move me. Thank you. All right. Well, I got just a couple more real quick. Ooh, what did I do? I have a strapless evening guitar suddenly. Oh, there we are. Okay. Well, you were right, Richard. That light just, man, blinds. But that's okay because that's showbiz. All right. Where was I? In tune when I bought it. I'll make them like these two. All right. All right. This next song is very new. I wrote this, feeling guilty. I wrote this about my old college sweetheart. This is called Rochelle. She was a beautiful girl, and I treated her. I was such a total ass. You always are when you're like 18, 19 years old, aren't you? And so my working title was I'm an Asshole, but that didn't really work, so I decided to call it Rochelle instead. Ever study psychology? Nobody? Okay, well, never mind then. Well, if you did, you would know, you would perhaps know how many people with obsessive compulsive disorder it takes to tune a guitar. Just one, all night. By the way, speaking of OCD, if you happen to work in a cubicle somewhere and you're really bored, you know, and this is truly evil, so maybe you shouldn't do it, but let's say you find out the guy in the next cubicle is attention deficit disordered. This is how you can have some fun. Just pull yourself up over the divider, you know, and say, hey, Bob, did you lock your house this morning? He will drive home. It's awesome. You'll be going like, wash those hands on the way out, you filthy animal. But at any rate, like I said. Yeah, I'm so stupid. I put it on the wrong dot. Sorry. That light's creating dots where there weren't dots before. Also in front of my eyes. Rochelle, I'm afraid I did not treat you well. You were the beauty and I the beast from hell. Youth is wasted on the young. There was acid on my tongue. And I burned you with it, didn't I, Rochelle? Rochelle,
I recall the smell of your perfume. Together in the shadows of my room, you were innocent and bright, but my eyes could not stand the light. Such a creature of darkness was I, Rochelle. Rochelle, offer my apology to you. If there was any penance I could do for that young and callous fool and all he put you through. But I have no excuse for that, Rochelle. If I could shed these years and go back there, feel your warm embrace again, I swear I'd wipe your tears with care and stroke your jet black hair and love you like the queen you are, Rochelle. And love you like the queen you are, Rochelle. Which we need to recover. The sex, the booze, the drugs, or maybe just each other. Every day I try again, I hit the reset button. Don't always get it right, but I wouldn't change it for the world. Yeah. And why I talk to myself, maybe because no one will listen. Maybe why I write these songs like a crazy man on a mission. And just like any lost cause, lost in the transmission. Maybe it's a waste of time, but I wouldn't change it for the world. Got a 50-50 chance that things will go my way. As the tables turn, sometimes you're blessed, sometimes you're burned, but that's okay. I would change it for the world. Well, yeah. Feel I can know too much, but I don't know enough. I'm widely read in ignorance and unable to shut up. And I know that lies in the beholder's eye. Yeah, I know the beauty lies. I would not change it for the world. Oh, yeah. Any given day, got a 50-50 chance that things will go my way. As the tables turn, sometimes you're blessed, sometimes you're burned, but that's okay. I wouldn't change it for the world. Hey. I know the beauty lies. I know the beauty lies. I know the beauty lies, but I wouldn't change it for the world.